Welcome to the NIO showroom here in Beijing, China. You know, this is a very young company, started in 2014, and for now it's pinning its hopes on that SUV right there. That's the ES8, and that's the car that has a lot of people in China saying that this electric vehicle brand, more than others here in China, can really compete with Tesla in the long run. So let's jump inside and talk about it a little bit. Really what it comes down to, the company's argument, is that they give you style and performance that matches a similar model in Tesla's lineup, except at about half the price. So this car costs about $65,000 or so. The other thing is that they have a different consumer experience, is what they say. So for example, if you use your app when you're at work, let's say you drive this car to work, you put it in the parking lot, use your app, you can get the company to come to the parking lot and actually charge the vehicle's battery for you. So that's one of the things they say they offer. All total, they call it a competitive advantage. Now, are they Tesla yet? Absolutely not. I mean, very few companies are or could be at that level for a number of different reasons. One, they've only delivered about 1,600 of these cars to customers so far as of the end of August. They're still operating at a major loss. They lost about $500 million in the first two quarters of 2018. And when it comes to revenue, they only reported revenues about $7 million or so by the end of June, compared to hundreds of millions, if not billions of dollars, for revenues for Tesla over the years. So that is in large part because NIO is still a young company, and there are still a lot of reasons for investors to feel bullish about investing in this company, starting with the fact that they're backed by internet giants Baidu and Tencent here in China, among others. And the Chinese government also really wants to see more electric vehicles on the road, and they're providing subsidies and financial incentives not only to people making these cars, but also to people buying them. And so if this IPO really is about anything, it's about potential. Can this company eventually get to the point where it can manufacture enough quality cars to compete with Tesla in the long run? There are many people here in China who say, yes, that is possible. The question is, will investors in the US and around the world begin to feel the same? Matt Rivers, CNN, Beijing.